the State Fairgrounds at Springfield, Illinois, gave us one of the most exciting and controversial finishes in memory for the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards. They've seen the white flag.
Here's AJ's got to get out of there.
AJ,
he's not left out.
This week, it's back to paper, the challenging half-mile speedway, where generations of talent have honed their racing skills. Today, both Ross Kenseth and Travis Sauter make their pro racing debuts. They'll follow in their father's footsteps, carrying the hopes and dreams of becoming a champion one day. For nearly 60 years, Madison International Speedway has been at the forefront of a rich Wisconsin short track racing heritage. Today, the NBC Sports Network presents the HERS Live Life with Flavor 200.
On this hot, sunny summer Sunday afternoon. Hello again, everyone. I'm Rick Benjamin. Is alongside today here in Madison, Wisconsin. Ken, this is the hottest day we've had for one of these NBC Sports Network telecasts.
Yeah, and that's going to make a difference, too. A lot of the guys came and tested last week. It's a lot hotter in test conditions, a lot hotter in practice and qualifying yesterday. It's going to make it harder on everything, harder on tires, harder on the driver. It's going to be very hot in that car, upwards to 140 degrees. Moving through lap traffic, everyone's going to be wiggling more, harder on brakes also.
And one of the challenges here in Madison, as I look down here, I think the asphalt's a little old. What do you think?
Yes, it is, and that's grip, which when it's hotter yet, you have less. But as drivers, that's what we like. That means there's not one spot on the track that's a whole lot better than everybody else, so you can move around and find out where your car likes it the best.
And the driver who solves that equation the best is liable to end up in victory lane at the end of the day. Here, let's find out more. Here's Jim Trado.
Well, guys, there's a lot of things going on here at Madison International Speedway. It's the third straight year they've raced here at this half mile, but it's the first time in bright sunshine. 2011, the ARCA Series returned here at a nighttime race. Last year, the race was rained under twilight. These hot conditions play a whole new factor for these teams. It's hotter than yesterday during practice and qualifying. To end up here in victory lane, it's a matter of this narrow racetrack providing track position opportunities on pit road. When to take two tires, when to take four tires in the six tire race. This pit lane is where it's all going to take place, and only one driver will end up here. We'll see after 200 laps who it's going to be.
Thank you, Jim Trado. Yesterday here in Madison, young Ross Kenseth grabbed the pole for today's event. First career pole in his first ARCA Pole Award presented by Ansel and Kenny Schrader. That's got to make you awfully darn happy.
Well, we're pretty happy with that, being he's in our car, but to bring Ross to his first ARCA race and for him to capture the pole, we're very excited.
Ought to be a contender today. Justin Boston, one of the championship chasers, will line up alongside young Kyle Benjamin third. Points leader Frank Kimmel back there in fifth.
Yeah, he's starting in fifth, but we know how Frank operates. If Frank starts somewhere like that in top five or six, you know he's got a good car, and he will be right there before the day's end.
Also want to watch Travis. Nine, the Rulo Brothers Ford. A lot of wins here at Madison and late models this year. Back of the field, how about Brendan Poole? Wins last week at Springfield. Not expected to run today. He takes over the 55.
Well, Brendan's been having a phenomenal year, and it's a little different hopping in a different car and starting in the back, but he's got plenty of time, and he'll be there too because the Venturini Motorsports team knows how to get around these places.
Absolutely. Our coverage today of the ARCA Racing Series on the NBC Sports Network being brought to you. Save big money on all your home improvement needs. By Allegiant, save with the best travel deals under the sun, only at Allegiant.com. And by Ansel Protective Products, for more than 100 years, the leader in hand protection. Madison International Speedway is actually a little bit south of the city of Madison, just outside Oregon, Wisconsin. Kenny Schrader, a high-banked half mile, and an unusual way to get into pit road.
Very tricky to get on pit road. You have to do it in the middle of turn three and four, and then the exit, as we see, it gets real tight. It'd be one car following the other ones off pit road for sure.
Pit road speed limit today, 23 miles an hour. You do get that little margin of error, right?
Yeah, they'll work with you 3 or 4 mile an hour. They don't really tell you what. It's 23, and that's the way you're supposed to figure it.
Field on the backstretch on Pace Labs here before we go green today, and the HERS Chase the Taste 200. Glad to have you with us this afternoon, fourth of our telecast on the NBC Sports Network. We've seen different winners go to victory lane. It's been a different look each time we've done one of these. Ken, this racetrack so different from the mild dirt last week at Springfield.
Oh, that's the deal about the ARCA Series. They go from one extreme to the other. 2.66 mile track to Elko, Minnesota, probably a third, which are smallest, to the road course, to the mild dirt, to you name it.
Today, 100 miles of racing, 11 degrees banking. I thought it was more than that.
The 11 degrees is really funny. When you walk across it, it looks like it's banked pretty much. When you're running 120, in excess of 120 mile an hour, you're hard on the brakes, and you go down to make the 180, it doesn't seem like very much.
Drivers that we'll see for the first time in an ARCA car today,
52 car on the front row with Ross Kenseth. Now, did you have a word with him before he got going today?
No, I haven't really seen Ross today, but more important than that is I think his daddy did, and I'm sure his daddy can help him a lot more than I can.
Matt Kenseth, of course, the winner Saturday night night race at Bristol in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series. Of course, NASCAR coming back to the NBC Sports Network here in the months to come, and Matt Kenseth, the guy we'll be talking about and hearing a lot about as the months go by. Kenseth on the pole, on the outside, Justin Boston from Baltimore in this Loop Computer and Electronics Recycling Toyota, part of the Venturini Motorsports stable. Inside of row two, Kyle Benjamin, not a full-timer, but very impressive teenager, lots of late model success in this part of the world, very strong in the ARCA Series. On the outside of row two, second in the championship, Mason Mingus in the 32 car, that dial 811 before your dig injury, still looking for his first career ARCA victory.
Yeah, but he's been knocking on the door and at a lot of different type tracks, so it's not going to be a surprise at all when Mason lands that car in victory lane. Ran a few races last year, kind of got his feet wet, and has really adapted well from his super late models into these.
Top of your screen, of course, running order as we go throughout the course of the afternoon here on the NBC Sports Network. Frank Kimmel, the nine-time champion of the ARCA Racing Series. Big points lead for Frank, 260 markers coming in here today with five races left in the 2013 season. Hard to envision a scenario where he would not be the 10-time champion, but for him, I think it's all about winning that 80th career ARCA race.
Well, longtime ARCA hero, legend, Iggy Katona, 79 races, most wins. Frank has now tied that, so he's shooting to become the all-time winningest driver. He's already the all-time lap leader. He's won the most championships, so I think he's going to be the mark that we all shoot for now.
He'll be trying for it here today in the Anselm Menards Toyota Jim Trader.
Hey guys, real quick on the 55 of Brennan Poole. He's a substitute driver. Yesterday, AJ Hendrickson had a practice crash, injured his arm, so they made the call to the bullpen. His nickname's the Bull. Well, he was not here. He was in Charlotte. He flew in last night. He has yet to turn a lap on this number 55 machine, but hats off to the crew. Jeff McClure and the team rebuilt the car. I said, Jeff, what'd you have to replace? He said, the motor pulleys forward. I don't have my pans where I want them. I don't have my brake ducting where I want them. We put it together with what we brought to the racetrack. Poole knows how to run here at Madison. He led laps early last year before fading to 10th after some brake issues. Poole, first laps in the car in the 55, will start row 9. I expect him not to be there for long.
Well, like we talked about in the opening, brakes are going to be a huge issue today, so I'd be a little bit concerned if things weren't like I wanted them to start the race.
Brennan Poole, though, very talented. 2 wins and 3 ARCA Racing Series starts so far this season. Safety truck is in on the backstretch here at Madison International Speedway. Field out of turn number 4. Ross Kenseth will set the pace. Glad to have you with us on the NBC Sports Network, and we are underway. Kenseth on the bottom. Brief jaunt to the lead, about 2 car lengths to the good over Justin Boston as they haul it down the backstretch. They're 3 wide in places here.
Well, we see the 55 car trying to charge up through, which is showing briefly in the screen. There we see him as he comes off turn 4, already making some good progress.
Brendan Poole hoping to get that car to the front quickly today. Kenny, we didn't talk about this earlier, but worth mentioning now. I've been here a couple of times to your telecast before. This is a place where you want to be on the bottom, isn't it?
Well, you want to be on the bottom. But a lot of times when you get going so slow to stay on the bottom, someone can roll around the outside of you. So just because you're on the bottom doesn't mean you're safe as far as getting past.
And, of course, a hot day, it could become very slick here. You may have to go up one grid, one width of the racetrack to be able to make a battle out of it. Here's Kimmel to the inside of the 15 of Kyle Benjamin. This is 4 position. This is for 4th spot as they come off turn 4. Ross Kenseth is still your leader.
Well, and right now at this point, a little contact there, you see. But right now at this point, you're just making laps. You're just making laps and trying to, you want to go just as fast as you can to stay in front of the people behind you.
J. Weltmeyer heads to pit road early. James Hilton off the pace as Ross Kenseth will put him 1 lap down. We've completed 4 of 200 laps this afternoon. Second spot belongs to Justin Boston. Mason Mingus is 3rd. Kyle Benjamin in the 15. And Frank Kimmel still duking it out for 4th.
We really see the track, it's already widening out pretty good. So, I mean, for the 15 car to be able to hang out the outside like that, that means we're going to have real good racing and actually, you know, he's progressing forward there.
3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th under a blanket. That's Mingus in the 32, the Wintron entry. On the outside, Benjamin in the white 15 scrapes the wall coming off turn 2. Kimmel takes advantage to go by and pick up a spot.
See Tom Hesser going right up behind them. I mean, that group is going to be, they're going to be locked together all day, I believe.
Kimmel still trying to close the deal and get by Benjamin there. And they scored in 4th last time by. Both cars heading to pit road on the backside as well. Kimmel moves up in front of Kyle Benjamin. He will settle in to fourth spot. Spencer Gallagher back there in sixth in the Allegiant Air car, the 23. Seventh belongs to Tom Hesser, one of our championship contenders, currently fourth in the title fight in the ARCA Racing Series. And Mingus in the 32 in third. Now, if you're Mason Mingus, Ken Schrader, and you're looking at this, everybody's settled down. Now, this group was too wide here for a while.
Like I say, you want to try to catch them. You want to really see how your car is compared to theirs, but you don't want to be grinding up your equipment yet. This is all about being good at the end of the race. It's not who goes the fastest. It's who completes the 200 laps first.
23 of Gallagher trying to get by Benjamin in the 15. This is for fifth spot. The 77 car of Tom Hesser III back there in seventh. Now remember, at the close of last week's 100-miler on the dirt at Springfield, Illinois, it was Gallagher and Hesser that got in with him.
Yeah, but that was after the checkered flag, so I'm sure it was an accident. I'll tell you what, you get in those cars and it's 104 degrees in there, and someone rubs up against you and you're not happy, and the tempers flare, and it's hard to control that.
Benjamin in the 15, the white Venturini entry there in fifth spot. Sixth is the Allegiant Air 23 of Gallagher. Seventh, the Barbara's Auto Store 77 car of Tom Hesser III. Fifth, sixth, and seventh, nose to tail. As your leader continues to be Ross Kenseth and the Blaine's Farm and Fleet 52. We'll be right back. 13 laps complete at Madison, Wisconsin. Welcome back to the show. Glad to have you with us. The Hers Live Life with Flavor 200. I'm Rick Benjamin. NASCAR star Ken Schrader is alongside Jim Trado with our coverage today on Pit Road. So far, you got to be happy with your new hire in the seat of that 52.
Well, we were real happy when we found out we were going to get the opportunity to bring Ross up here. But, yeah, he's doing a good job. Unfortunately, it's lap 14.
Nobody paid on lap 14, right?
And last 186, we're not too sure about yet.
Second spot belongs to the Salute 25, Justin Boston, one of the championship contenders out of the Venturini Stables, currently third in points. Ross Kenseth has won a lot of races here in a super late model. How close is a late model to these 3,400-pound cars?
Oh, it's quite a bit of different. It's close to 1,000 pounds lighter. The steering, his rack and pinion steering, because of the lighter, it has less power. Power to weight is probably about the same, but it just has more grip. It's more forgiving. These cars, when you overdrive them, it's hard for the same width tire, to hold that extra 1,000 pounds. So it's a learning curve, but he has excelled so good in the other car that we felt confident that it wouldn't be a problem for him.
Frank Kimmel meets up at the 44, trying to get around Mason Mingus for third. Remember, those two had some history when we were at Berlin Raceway in Michigan a few weeks ago. A lot of contact there. Kimmel and Mingus not happy with each other when the night was over. Here's Frank trying to work the outside on the 32.
You know, when you run the full ARCA series, you're just going to have some contact with people here and there.
Kind of inevitable in this sort of racing. Why we love short track racing, isn't it?
No, they run so close, all the time, that there's going to be some situations developed.
Mingus in the 32. Kevin Sawinski's Wintron entry, the Dial-A-1 One Before You Dig sponsored entry. In front of the Ansel Menards Toyota of Kimmel, third and fourth on the racetrack. Frank Kimmel, I know, so badly wants to get that 80th career win here as quickly as possible, get that milestone out of the way, and back to the business of winning another ARCA Racing Series championship. It would be his first in several years since he joined ThorSport in 44. Meantime, out in front continues to be Ross Kenseth in the Blaine's Farm and Fleet 52 car, moving by the two of Thomas Prater.
You know, a lot of times when you want something and you're working at that one goal, that much harder, it gets harder to achieve. But Frank has been so steady and so rock solid throughout his whole career. And when he joined ThorSport, you talk about rejuvenating. They had the resources necessary to really give him championship material.
Absolutely. And fielding these ARCA teams, Kenny, you do this. You drove that car to victory at Toledo Speedway in Ohio earlier this season. Not an easy thing to do. It takes a lot of work, takes a lot of resources as we watch the fight here for fifth and sixth.
Yeah, they're right on each other. That's a good run there.
No question about it. The Allegiant Air 23 of Gallagher holding down sixth position. Hesser and the Barbara's 77 in seventh, one of the Cunningham Dodges. And for these ARCA Racing Series teams, it is a fight a lot of times for resources to do the job, get the job done. And you know what that's like as a team owner, as well as a veteran driver in all levels of NASCAR.
Well, it really is. These cars are the NASCAR Sprint Cup cars before they went to the COT cars. These are basically the same rules. They have tremendous horsepower, over 850 horsepower. It costs about the same amount of money to run one of these as it does everything else. Our tires cost the same, engines cost the same. So it's a pretty much a labor of love to keep bringing these cars to the racetrack every week.
Ross Kenseth hoping to follow in his dad's footsteps, make it to Sunday's racing in NASCAR. Ross still the leader. There's the second place entry of Justin Boston out of Baltimore, Maryland, and that's Luke 25. The gap is about a second and a half. First 2 seconds translates to about a straightaway here. Battle tightening up for third. Mingus in the 32 trying to dive to the bottom under Milka Duno. Gets there. Kimmel, meantime, hung out on the outside. He'll have to wait.
Yeah, he was looking at no man's land up there. You know, we've seen that second groove come in, but he was looking at that third group there, but didn't quite have the grip to complete the pass, so he got back down and won.
Third, fourth, and fifth in play. That's Kyle Benjamin in the 15, the ISC Racers tape entry in fifth position now. As Kimmel will drop to the bottom, and it's got to be so frustrating. You've got 200 laps. You might look at that and say, well, that's a long afternoon. It's really not. It's about an hour 10 of racing here. You get to somebody, and then lap traffic forces you to back out of the gas.
200 laps goes by pretty quick, especially sometimes when you're a midfield car, and you're going along and thinking you're okay, and then they tell you the leader's a quarter lap. And you get that lap down, and it starts ruining your day, so you've got to go.
Kimmel now reeling Mingus back in. This is the battle for third. Kenseth and Boston still alone, one and two. Toward lap 30 here this afternoon in Madison, Wisconsin.
We're seeing that bottom pretty much predominant right now. You know, you watch those guys between 3 and 4, and they are real close to that inside wall.
Yeah. So you see that in some places. It's got to be difficult as a driver to have to look left all the time and look across that wall. You're not maybe sure what you're seeing.
Yeah, well, you're used to hitting stuff anyway, so it's not that big a deal. You know, the track reminds me a lot of Toledo. Banking similar. And then the other thing is, you run the left front, the left side, right down at the bottom of the racetrack, and there's no apron or anything down there. You know, your next grip for traction is grass, so that doesn't work too good.
If you hook the wheel off on the inside, you're going for a big ride.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Working around the zero car, that's James Swanson today from Clarksboro, New Jersey. Mingus continues to hang on to third, and then black dial 8-1-1 entry. Kimmel in fourth in the Ansel Menard's machine. The spot is Benjamin, the ISC Racers tape car, the 15, and he's about half a dozen car lengths behind that battle for fourth and fifth. We'll make that third and fourth. Coming up on James Harvey Hilton in the 48, his retirement tour. James still out there. Brennan Poole in the 55, a little further back, has cracked the top 10. Dial from Easley, South Carolina. James Hilton, we just saw him just a few moments ago. James out there running in 18th position, a couple of laps down to the leaders already as we continue to watch the fight for third between Mingus and Kimmel, all this allowing the two leaders to stretch it out. You've got Boston now about 1.2 seconds behind the race leader, Ross Kenseth. Mason Mingus back another 2.5 seconds. There's Ross on the backstretch here at Madison.
You know, you have to know in your mind what changes you're going to want to make to the car. If it's tightening up or it doesn't want to turn, or if it's getting a little bit too free or it slides too much, when you're going to want to take two tires, when you're going to want to take four. That's what's all you're processing through your mind now at lap 33 to gear up for the rest of the race.
Well, you've got in the 52 with Ross Kenseth, you've got a veteran crew chief. Donnie Richardson has been with you a long time overseeing things. How valuable is a guy like Donnie to this effort?
Donnie's unbelievable value. He's just been here, done that for a long time. He's very valuable to me when I'm driving the car. Whenever we have younger drivers that haven't run in the heavier type cars before, he's a tremendous help all the time.
As Ross Kenseth continues to lead, 34 laps go on the board here at Madison International Speedway. He's got a significant lead over Justin Boston. Less than a second right now. Mingus is third, Kimmel and Kyle Benjamin. We'll be back on the NBC Sports Network. Welcome back to Madison International Speedway. We're in Madison, Wisconsin on the NBC Sports Network. Coverage of the HERS Live Life with Flavor 200. Ross Kenseth started on the pole today in the 52. He has led all the way so far. This fight rages on. This is for third and fourth. Mason Mingus in the 32, Frank Kimmel in the 44. And we're joined topside by the dad of our race leader, Matt Kenseth, who won at Bristol Motor Speedway, the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series last night. Good to see you. How are you?
Thanks. I'm doing good. But Ross is only 10, so it's okay.
I was going to say.
I'm really young.
You're not old enough to have a driver that.
Makes me feel old when you introduce me like that. But yeah, we had a great night at Bristol. Obviously, that was pretty cool. And come up here and watch Ross. Will Schrader's car here has been.
That was a little exciting, wasn't it, there, Matt?
Yeah.
Working through the
last. I start stuttering.
What does it mean to you? This is a sport that's always been passed down from fathers to sons and fathers to daughters. What does it mean to you to see this happen?
Well, I'm happy for Ross when he's happy. So I'm one of them guys that have never really pushed him to race or not to race. If this is what he wants to do, and he likes doing it, and he works hard at it. It's something that I know a little bit about and I can help him with, so I really, really enjoy that. So, like I said, happy that he's getting this opportunity. Been real proud of him for a lot of reasons, not just what he does on the racetrack, but real proud of him. So it's fun to see him have some success.
This is a place you're very familiar with as well, as we watch the fight between Kimmel and Mingus here for third spot down in turn three. How tough a racetrack is this?
You know, it seems like it's getting tougher by the years. It's getting wore out. I remember when they first repaved this place. So, yeah, I spent a lot of time racing here. It's only 20 minutes from where I grew up. So it's really neat to come back here and be able to catch an ARCA race.
Always great to see you. And certainly coming off the win last night, we watched this battle here for third, this half-mile high bank kind of a paperclip layout. How difficult will it be today with the hot weather?
That's a good question. I kept telling Ross to stay hydrated. He's used to running some long races, but never in these car. Although I'm sure with his car owner, he has nothing but the best driver comfort stuff in there.
Yeah, he's probably got a vent when he sticks his hand out the window, I would think.
And he has a drink if he brought one with him.
Yeah, if he brought something to drink, he's got something to drink.
Doesn't seem to be bothering him any at this moment as we watch the battle here again for third. Kimmel on the bottom will slip by the 32 of Mingus and take that spot over. Frank Kimmel gunning for that 80th career victory in the ARCA Racing Series here as we close in on lap 50. Matt, you talked earlier, I know going into the season, Ross now a college student down at Clemson, wanting to get him some opportunities here at ARCA in the Truck Series, that sort of thing. It's a battle, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, this has worked out great, although we're not done with the race yet, but you know, with Schrader here, he'd be able to put together some sponsorship for him to get in this car, and obviously Kenny's got a first-class program. So it's neat to get him in his car, first experience in a big, heavy car. He's got a lot of experience in late miles all over the country and has had some success with that. So, you know, this is the next logical step. You know, it seemed like a no-brainer coming to a track he has a lot of experience with and getting in a good car.
Well, and last year he kind of had a breakout here. He won some huge races last year.
Yeah, that year he won All-American 400, the Winchester 400, and the Redbud 300. So three of the biggest five short track races really in the country he was able So that was an amazing end to the season. He won races that never was even close to winning. So that was a good finish to the season for him.
Yeah. And there's no way he can be 20 because you've got a two-year-old at home.
Yeah. No, I don't know how that happens.
Well, it's great to see Ross Kenseth in that 52 car and see him leading here as we get closer and closer to lap 50 on the board today at Madison International Speedway. He's got a good advantage back to 1.2 seconds over Justin Boston, working his way through slower traffic. Battle here, Kimmel on the 44 car on the high side, trying to get closer to Boston for second, puts the six a lap down. That's Will Gallagher making his first start of the season in a Sharps car. Bill Caduno there on the bog. Gallagher goes around, our first caution of the day. We'll wave here on lap 49. Gallagher on the high side, just a little too slick up there.
Wow, it looked like it was real too slick. You know, hopefully we get to see a replay there, but that was a hard impact.
Yeah, I didn't see it, but I heard it, and that's never good.
No, whenever you hear it. And we're not looking at safer barriers here. Softer walls. That just means that they're softer.
Yeah. Still a hard hit. Will Gallagher with the window net down in the sixth car up between turns one and two. One more look at it here. Hauling down into the corner. Kimmel in the middle of the track slipped, and Gallagher had nowhere to go.
Well, the way he didn't even start to arc in would almost make me think he had some kind of either brake issue or throttle issue or something. It looked a little weird there.
It did look weird. It looked like Kimmel slowed up and he was going to follow him around outside. It almost looked like he locked the brakes up or something. I'm not really sure. That was very, very weird looking. Hard to figure that one out.
Bill Caduno on the bottom getting lapped by Kimmel. Gallagher was there in the mix as well. Hits the wall hard up between one and two. Window net drops down. That's the universal signal that the driver is fine. The ARCA safety truck on the scene quickly. G-Force providing that, of course, the safety initiative. And they're talking to Will Gallagher inside that race car.
Now at lap 51, with six tires in the pits, what do we think we want to do, man?
That's why I drive and don't pit.
That's
so
why he
last night, you know. You know, I don't know. The pace is he's dropping off here a little bit. 11 cars in the lead lap. You maybe come and get your first two tires. I'm not sure, but it's funny. Jason asked me last night. We had like 60 to go. And he's like, well, what do you think, Matt? You think we should be like, oh, no. You're not. No. You make that call. I'll be happy with whatever call you made. And the one he made, I was most happy with.
He tells me this morning, said, yeah, we kind of really messed up and didn't do what we wanted to, and so we wound up winning.
No, I made a dumb mistake not paying attention on pit road and got a speeding penalty and got us behind.
Sometimes the best laid plans don't matter. It right? Doesn't work out at all. Race leader Ross Kenseth on pit road for his first stop of the afternoon. The Schrader Racing 52 car. First pit stall. Good to have that one. Jim Tredo is there.
Indeed. Ross Kenseth talked about the car being a bit tied off as the race wore on here. That's the first caution flag, first opportunity. He hadn't said a whole lot on the radio to this point. A chassis adjustment in the right rear window. Two right side tires on Ross Kenseth's car. They're on the two right side tires. He's down and away with a small right front tire pressure adjustment as well, as the call by crew chief Donnie Richardson.
Looks like Kyle Benjamin will be next off pit road. And then Spencer Gallagher. Remember, you don't race off pit road here in the ARCA Racing Series on the short tracks, being held at the end of pit road to blend back in on the backside. Mason Mitchell in the 82 did not qualify terribly well today. Next in line, but a lap down. Tom Hessert will be fourth on the restart at the 77. And then the 0-2 of Josh Williams. Looks like he may move up a few spots as well as the lead lap cars come to pit road. Brennan Poole in the 55 had worked his way up into the top 10. He gets service on the Venturini entry, the ECC car, and he'll come around the backside and be ready to go. Lap down cars next to come to pit road. And the indication is from the ARCA Racing Series officials, Ross Kenseth too fast on pit road, so he will have to take a penalty for that.
I'm not aware what the penalty is for that. Is it a lap or if it's 10?
If it's a drive-through.
It's a drive-through.
I didn't even know they kept track of speed on pit road.
Yes,
23 do. Miles an hour.
23 miles an hour.
23. Oh,
23.
How can you go 23? That's what I said.
Well, it's, I mean, it's,
you know, so here's how drivers do it. I'd stay out.
Yeah. Well, if he can serve the penalty under the yellow, it'll be at the end of the world.
Exactly. So he'll drop in toward the back of the field. Rollback is out to pick up the Eddie Sharp Racing 6 car, Will Gallagher. So that was indeed a hard hit. We'll be under caution for a few more laps. Let's take a break. We'll come right back at Madison, Wisconsin. Caution continuing here at Madison International Speedway, the Hurs Live Life with Flavor 200. Welcome back on the NBC Sports Network. I'm Rick Benjamin. Ken Schrader is alongside Jim Tredo on pit road. We're joined topside by Matt Kenseth, the most recent winner in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Bristol Motor Speedway, the Bristol Night Race last Saturday night. Justin Boston in the 25 will take over for the restart lead. Frank Kimmel will move up to second in front of the 32 of Mason Mingus. And then the 22 will move into fourth. That's young Anderson Bowen out of South Carolina, stepping into one of the Cunningham Dodges today for the first time. Looks as though the 52 of Ross Kenseth will fall into line next. The penalty is on the short track. You fall into the end of the longest line for Ross. So, Kenny, as you were saying, that's not a terrible handicap to overcome.
Yeah, it's definitely nobody wants to be handicapped, but, you know, you have to pay the price when you don't do right. So.
And Matt, even guys at your level have that happen to them sometimes.
Yeah,
not to mention any
night.
Games.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, I mean, it's a little bit more, more technical, with all the timing lines and all that stuff, and we map all that out, and everybody, tries to get what you can. But I will say, at short tracks, the slower pit road speed is, the easier it is to speed. You know, it's so easy to go a mile or two over. I was 0.2 miles an hour over last night just from a mental error, not paying enough attention to the tack and looking at something else. So it can happen easily, as we see. So hopefully he won't do that again. Got 150 laps here to try to get his position back.
Kenny, all the conventional wisdom we were hearing up and down pit road before the start, when you get the opportunity, you take two fresh tires, save four for later in the race.
Well, I think so. At the end is usually when you have to do most of your racing. It's the most important part of the race. That's when you need to be leading. And, to have the four tires there, it should be better.
Jim Tredo with the 99 of Travis Sauter back on pit road.
Back on pit road, guys. They have spent 9 laps behind the wall here, actually on pit road, putting brake fluid in the Lester Buildings Ford. Travis came down on that pit road and said the pedal goes to the floor, so they've actually added more brake fluid. But again, a young driver who's won 10 consecutive Super Late Model races here at this track, for the first time experiencing that 3,400-pound race car, losing the brakes early. Now they're adjusting again to get more brake fluid put in the number 99 here on pit road under the caution. But again, lost 9 laps here as one of these next generation drivers makes his foray in the ARCA Racing Series. Let's see if he can make any of those laps back up based upon his experience here.
As the 6 goes up on the rollback, Will Gallagher with a very hard hit up between turns 1 and 2. Kenny, on a day like this, over 90 degrees here, could you boil the brake fluid? You told me earlier in the week, you bought the big brake package.
Well, Matt has got a lot more laps here than I do, but we came here for an ASA race one time years ago, and it was the day after Bristol, flew up here, and Robbie Reiser had qualified my car for me.
Really?
And I hopped in it, and we got up to like second place with 20 to go and lost the brakes because it's pretty hard on brakes.
Yeah, it's a hard braking track, especially if you're not used to these cars. They have so much horsepower, they're so heavy, and don't handle like a super late model, so you really have to watch that. It's not as bad as Martinsville, but certainly it's a pretty heavy braking track, especially if your car's not doing the things you want it to do.
Safety truck still out in front of the field here at Madison International Speedway. Justin Boston in that 25 will have the restart pole. Here comes the 52 back down pit road for another stop. What's going on here, Kevin?
Well, they might just be coming through, make an adjustment or something, and then go back out and already be back at the longest line instead of falling back, top it off with fuel or what. Can't have too much fuel. Just no telling. But they have to go to the back anyway, so this is a good time to maybe make an adjustment.
Like
he might want something.
Standing there.
Yeah. No, we're going to go to the right rear, make adjustment, clean off the grill, and he might want something to drink because I don't know if we gave him anything to drink.
Maybe that's why he spent.
Yeah.
So Ross will take the 52 off of pit road slowly this time. He'll come around to the stop and go sign on the backside. He'll have to blend in off the backstretch here at Madison International Speedway. 57 laps on the board, 200 in our first caution period of the day. Cleanup looks to be just about complete up between turns 1 and 2. Will Gallagher spinning there. It was a strange looking wreck from the standpoint that Milcaduno was down on the bottom, going another lap down to the lead lap cars. Frank Kimmel up in the middle of the track looked as though he bobbled just a little bit when he got to the 35. And I think Gallagher may just have gone in there too hot.
Yeah, it just looked a little unusual, but the main thing is he's okay in it because it was a hard impact.
That was a hard hit.
Yeah, when you hear them first.
Yeah, no doubt, and they needed the rollback to get that car off the racetrack, so that's another sign, no doubt about it. Looks as though we're a lap or so away from going green once again here at Madison. Lights still on the safety truck. 99 off of pit road, heading to the back of the field. Show you one more time what brought out our first yellow of the day here at Madison. Down into turn one, that's Kimmel in the yellow car, lapping Milcaduno there at the 35 on the inside. Here's Gallagher on the high side.
It just never even started to turn till way late.
Knocked the back lip off that pretty much, hitting so hard, and then got the front end as well. So that's baptism by fire in the ARCA Racing Series for a young driver.
Yes, most definitely. You learned a lot that race. And Eddie Sharp, I mean, that's good equipment.
It is.
Yeah, former car owner champion.
Absolutely. Justin Lofton drove Eddie's equipment to a championship in the ARCA Racing Series here a couple of years ago. Eddie, a truck series owner in NASCAR as well. Continue to circulate under caution here at Madison International Speedway. One lap till restart here at Madison International Speedway. Getting set to go. It'll be lap number 60 of 200. Of course, the caution laps do count. Now, last week on the Dirt Mile at Springfield, Illinois, we had extended overtime. We had a couple of opportunities for green-white checker restarts. And the rule at ARCA is you can have as many as it takes. If you get to the white flag and then have a caution, you would race just the one lap. So we'll see how this plays out this afternoon. But overtime, even more of a crapshoot in the ARCA Racing Series than what you would normally think of. Safety truck is in. Lead lap cars on the high side here at Madison International Speedway. So Boston in the 25. The 69 of Will Kimmel on the bottom, or actually Michael Lira in the other Kimmel Racing entry. The 69 on the inside, a lap down car. Green flag is out. Frank Kimmel in second spot will go for the lead heading into turn one. Kimmel on the bottom. Boston slips up high, and Kimmel may come out the victor in this little battle as they head toward turn three.
He's certainly got the preferred line there and easily moves up in front.
Frank Kimmel grabs the point on lap 61 here in Madison. Now we'll see how good that race car really is today.
Well, he was holding his own the whole time with the leaders when he had got up to third, so I think he's got good equipment there. I mean, he's got cars ready to go.
Mason Mingus in the Dial 811 Before You Dig entry sits third. Anderson Bowen in the Cunningham Dodge, the 22 in fourth spot. His first career start in the series. Kyle Benjamin back there in fifth in the 15. Spencer Gallagher in the 23. Up to sixth now as the 22 slips up high. Benjamin in the 15 on the bottom, gunning for a position. Side by side out of turn four. This is for fourth spot.
Well, it really looks like you want to get off on the bottom and get that straight run up off on the bottom if at all possible.
Yeah, it looks like there's a lot of two-wide traffic there. Curious to see how Ross gets rolling here once they get cleared.
The 15, the 22, and the 23 all involved in a fight for fourth, fifth, and sixth. Right behind him, Tom Hesse, the third of the 77. He is in seventh spot. The 0-2 of Josh Williams in eighth. Brendan Poole now in the 55, moving by him to pick up a spot. So Brendan Poole in that 55 car, relief driving this weekend as we watch Gallagher in the 23 go to the bottom, trying to get by Anderson Bowen, and he looks like he's got the spot.
Well, Gallagher and Tom Hesser have been solid all day right there. And, just as the laps go on, that's when they'll start showing us what they've got.
Anderson Bowen, another youngster, late model veteran of the Southeastern United States, learning the hard way that these heavy cars could be a handful. 65 laps into a 200-lap event. Tom Hoesser moves by and picks up six spots. 69 car back there. Michael Lira in 13th position. He is one lap down. Benjamin here trying to close in on Mingus in the 32 for third. Gallagher in the 23 back there in fifth. They're nose to tail out of turn four. Benjamin letting that 15 get up high coming off the corner. Do you want to hold a car down coming off the corner here? Is this a place where you really want to let it get outside quickly?
Yeah, I've never ran a heavy car here, but typically in a late model car here, it's one of those tracks you want to make a real late apex and then get kind of diamond a corner, get a nice straight low drive off the corner, especially turn two always seemed to be the key to me here. Is your entry to one, you can set up turn two and drive under them off of two, finish your pass in turn three. You know, when I used to run here a lot, it seemed like the place to pass.
Jim Trano, the 15 of Kyle Benjamin, turning a nice run here today. But trouble on the backstretch. Lira in the 69 before we can get to that story. Michael Lira in the Gary Ellman's Ford spins down on the grass, and that will bring out our second caution of the afternoon.
Yeah, he spun around all right, but he had plenty of help.
I'm sure we'll get another look at it as they come off turn two.
Yeah, the 55 got into him and never got off him.
Brendan Poole in the 55. Lira, the first car one lap down. Here's another look at what happened. This is the entrance to turn one. Here's Lira in the blue 69. Poole in the 55, last week's winner at Springfield. Probably thought he had enough room to get by on the inside.
Well, usually when you see him start to get a little bit sideways, that's the first clue that
get on the brakes.
You're steering them. You're steering them, and they might need a little help.
Is their spoiler starts getting higher?
Yeah. You can see by his right front there that he wasn't in him just a little bit.
It looked like he was trying to get that move on the bottom, and at the same time, it looked like that 69 car maybe moved down a little bit to get out of the way of the lead lap cars, and they were both kind of committed at the same time.
Not enough real estate for both those cars off turn two. There's Poole in the 55.
That's all we're doing when we go out there. It's 200 laps of car wrestling. We're just all wrestling over space.
Looks like pit road is open. This will bring Frank Kibble, the lead lap cars, to a stop. Mingus stops. Boston comes to a halt. The Thor Sport crew will go to work on Kibble's 44 car.
Well, that penalty didn't seem to be too big a deal. Kind of evened it back up and got it back to the front.
There you go.
Well, seeing that the other Frank Kimmel and the 25 car came in and they took two tires too, so everybody's going to shake out about where they were, and then we'll put in the laps until everybody does their four tire stop.
So Kimmel will be first off pit road in the sequence. He gives up the lead. That'll put Kyle Benjamin on the restart pole in the 15. Spencer Gallagher, Hessert, Ross Kenseth will be back to fourth of the 52. Bowen will restart fifth as things currently stand in the 22. Those cars have not yet. Well, Bowen did come to pit road, so we'll see where they stack up when the field blends back together. Jim Trano, Frank Kibble gives up the lead to take tires.
And he pitted from the lead. There was a debate really under that last lap before pit lane opened up. They were wondering, is this the time we want to pit or do we want to wait longer? They like the handling of their car to this point, but they said we can't wait. His crew chief, Jared Prince, said we got to take the two now. We don't know how long it'll be before the next caution. We need to take those two now. That's what forced Frank and the rest of the guys that had yet to pit to come down pit road.
Brendan Poole stopping briefly in the 55, but they've got more work to do on that next year.
Yeah, well, it messed up the right front pretty good. And then we saw what looks like traces of concrete there on the right front. I didn't really understand that.
Yeah, it's on both sides in their pit stall. I don't know if they had a little brake fire and tried to put it out or what they did, but it's a lot of white powder flying off that car when he took off.
So Poole in the 55 back on the racetrack, but he'll probably have to come back to pit road. Still under caution with 72 laps on the board here at Madison International Speedway. Right back on the NBC Sports Network. Flagman showing the field one lap until we get a restart here at Madison International Speedway. The Venture 80 Motorsports crew hard at work on the 55 car on pit road a moment ago. The two car of Thomas Prater getting some late service as well before we come back to green. Now the 55 back on pit road. Let's take a look at this. Matt Kenseth Ross here at the tail end of this line. There's the contact over in turn two between the 55 and the 69. Quick move to the outside.
Yeah, it looked like that was a good time to take a right. So, yeah. He's seen that happening and moved up and got around that, luckily. So, you always hate to see a wreck in front of you because you're never sure which way you go is going to be the right one.
One thing we have to think about here is there's some several cars in the front that have not pitted. We are in the spot where if this thing goes green, everyone that's been in and topped off and put on the two tires can run it out. I mean, they have the fuel. That's something Mr. Donlevy taught me years ago. Whenever it gets to that point where you know you can finish,
Be ready for it.
Fill that thing up with fuel.
Green flag is back in the air. Kyle Benjamin of the 15 takes him down into turn one. Spencer Gallagher of the 23, the Allegiant Air Machine in second. Here's Hester on the bottom in the 77. The Barbara's Auto Center car. He's got it for second spot. Ross Kenseth is fourth in the 52. Josh Williams in the 02 next in line. And Frank Kimmel back there in the 44. Pitted from the lead, shown sixth. Tom Hessert on fire in the 77, rolls underneath the 23 and picks up second position.
And that's Tom on his original four tires, I believe.
Yeah.
He has not been in the pits yet, so Tom and the 77 car are handling extremely good.
Kyle Benjamin out of South Carolina in good shape up front. 69 car Mike Alira back on the racetrack, maybe slowing things down a little bit where he is as we watch Benjamin start to stretch it out over Hessert. Ross Kenseth is third in the 52, the 23. Spencer Gallagher is fourth. His teammate Josh Williams next in line in front of Kimmel off of turn four, trying to get to fifth is Frank Kimmel right now as they arc it into turn one here in Madison.
You know, it doesn't look like the tires have been a huge help.
No, they don't seem to be slicing through there the way that you would think they would have been watching Ross a little bit and trying to get a move on him. It seems to be slipping a little bit more than I thought it would be.
Tire, of course, at Hoosier Short Track Radial. Hoosier's been building tires for the ARCA Racing Series for a long, long time. And by all accounts, brought a good tire here today for Madison on a hot summer afternoon, late in the summer of 2013.
That's quite the challenge when, you know, you talk about the competitors going from Talladega to a dirt track to a road course, and then here's Hoosier has to supply tires for everybody and go to all those different type tracks too.
Road course racing as well. Here's Kenseth on the bottom of the 52. He wants second. Hessert hung on the outside of the 77.
Well, Tom's got a lot of laps in that 52 car, so it's kind of, he knows what it can do, and we know definitely what he can do, so he's a good competitor.
Ross Kenseth moving back to second spot in the Blaine's Farman Fleet 52 car. See what he has from Kyle Benjamin in the 15, who has bolted out to a 1.3-second advantage after not pitting on that last sequence. Frank Kimmel has closed in the 44. He sits in fifth position now on Gallagher's rear deck lid. That's the blue 23 that Gallagher drives. Kimmel in the Ansel Menards entry, the 44.
Gallagher has just gotten stronger and stronger every week. They've really making progress.
And their program has improved significantly. He missed a couple of races earlier this season, suffered a concussion at Michigan in the ARCA Racing Series. He had to sit out 2 weeks, but since he's come back from that, he's been stout every week.
It's easy to hit your head in these things, isn't it, man?
Yeah. And you and I have talked about it before. Sometimes we don't feel like we're the smartest people in the world anyway, so when you hit your head on top, you know, on top of that, sometimes that's not good.
You
gotta sometimes
take
it knocks sense into you.
Yeah, sometimes. But it didn't work for him. He came back.
Sixth position belongs to the 02 of Josh Williams, the other Allegiant Air entry. This is the battle for third, fourth, and fifth. Tom Hessert in the 77. Spencer Gallagher in the 23. Here's Kimmel in the 44 to the bottom.
Thing about Frank Kimmel, it just doesn't matter which one of the tracks you're on the ARCA Series. He's just right there.
Watched him win so many races at places like Salem and Winchester over the years. He's a terror on the dirt. Last week at Springfield didn't work out for him at the end, but the guy is the all-time leading dirt track winner in ARCA. Up front, meantime, Kyle Benjamin in the 15 car, Bill Venturini's team, with a 1.08-second lead here at Madison International Speedway.
Yeah, one of four of the Bill Venturini teams that are here today.
Young driver who's very, very impressive. Matt, we were joking before when you first joined us here in the booth about how you have a 20-year-old son. Hard to believe that. And a lot of times, some of these kids, 15, 16 years old, so strong.
Yeah, it's crazy how different it is these days than what it was. I never started driving race cars until I was 16, and now people would be like, 16, he didn't start driving yet. He's never going to have a career. You know, they're all starting so little.
Jim Trano, what about Kyle Benjamin, who's leading this race?
Well, his age matches his car number, 15. Those older tires yesterday should help me when we have long runs here today, and it's certainly paying off with you.
think that our crew chief yesterday ran Ross on a lot of the older tires, too, because of, I hate buying tires. You know, that's one of the main reasons. But, no, it's how your car handles on older tires is what wins you in the races most of the time.
Yeah, for sure. This is a comment how warm it is for Wisconsin this time of year. It's a really, really hot day. This track, the asphalt, walking across it this morning, I didn't realize how wore out it's really gotten, the cracks, and how slick it's going to be. So you need to be set up for these conditions, and you're not going to have new tires at the end of the race, at least at the very end of the race. So it's you got to get it set up to run on old tires when it comes.
Of course, you never know when those cautions will fall. We've had two kind of back-to-back here, but we could be in. You could go 70 laps here under green.
Easily. I believe it was the Elko race, wasn't the Elko race that ran a long time before they had a yellow.
Frank Kibble in third spot of the 44, starting to track down the leaders. 3.2 seconds is the gap between Kyle Benjamin and Frank Kibble at this point, first to third. Spencer Gallagher, Hessert is fifth, Mingus in the 32, Boston the 25, and the restart leader. Mason Mitchell starting to make up some ground. He's on the lead lap in eighth in the 82. Josh Williams, Anderson Bowen, the rest of the top 10. We watch Kibble and Gallagher, third and fourth. Kind of settling down here at Madison International Speedway. We had some wild action just a few moments ago with a couple of incidents over in turns one and two. Now Kyle Benjamin laying down some good laps in that 15 car.
We're closing in on halfway here, just seven laps from halfway. You're going to have to position yourself to know what you have then.
By this point, you should have, I would think, a driver with a good bit of experience in any kind of race car would say, okay, I know what the track conditions are. I know what I've got here today. When do you start planning? When do you start thinking ahead? When do I want to stop if it's green? Or you think you talked about worn tires. Do you think it's a situation where your car, the 52, could go all the way home now on those
The 52 and the 44 can go all the way home. We have to remember, we have a mandatory pit stop before lap 190. So we know that the 15 has to pit sometime. Well, everyone has
pitted. Yeah, it looks like the 15 of Benjamin has made at least one stop to this point. Thought I'd seen him on pit road earlier there. So, yeah, everyone has made at least that one stop. You've got four tires, in most cases, left to take if you get the opportunity in the second half of this one. Closing in on halfway at Madison International Speedway. We'll come right back with more of the ARCA Racing Series. Welcome back to Madison International Speedway. Just outside Madison, Wisconsin on the NBC Sports Network. I'm Rick Benjamin, NASCAR star Ken Schrader. Is alongside Jim Tredo has our pit road coverage. We're joined topside by Matt Kenseth, our most recent winner in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series, the Bristol Night Race earlier this week. Matt wins, comes up here to watch his son Ross in action in his debut in the ARCA Racing Series. Ross Kenseth right now second in Ken Schrader's 52. Perfect symmetry here today. But the race leader is young Kyle Benjamin in the 15 car. And Kyle, one of a host of drivers who share those seats in the ARCA, the Venturini Motorsports entries here in the ARCA Racing Series. Kyle making his sixth start of the season. Of course, he's not old enough yet to run on the big tracks. Had a second at Mobile early in the year, a seventh at Elko. He was eighth at Winchester when we began our run of coverage here on the NBC Sports Network. Good to see him back in that race car. Very impressive young driver. And now you were talking a moment ago about Ross winning some of the big late model shows, the Red Bud 300, the All-American 400. Kyle Benjamin's been a contender in some of those too, hasn't he?
Yeah, for sure. There's a lot of great young talent coming up through the ranks right now, as there always is. But yeah, there's a lot of great young drivers out there. Ross has been able to race against a lot of guys up around the Midwest, up around Wisconsin, and then also moving south and racing against a whole other group of drivers. So I always feel like that helps to race a lot of different racetracks against a lot of different competitors.
Just past halfway as we watch Frank Kibble in the 44, your third place runner. Kibble about 3.9 seconds behind the leader right now. Not gaining much ground, but the car seems to be working pretty well, Ken Schrader.
Yeah, he's getting around there good. It looks like he's maybe just a couple tenths. His last lap, he was a couple tenths off from the first two cars. But he's been right there. It looks like the first five cars are all running real close to the same lap times.
Once again, on Thomas Prater in the Realtor.com 2 car. There's your race leader, Benjamin, in the 15.
I remember coming up here to race years ago, Matt, and we thought you were a kid. And you were.
I was.
You were a kid, but I mean, you were 17, 18, and competing. I mean, winning races out of, you know, the tracks around here. And a bunch of us would come up and have fun. And that's when we first got to know you. And, you know, Matt the Brat, you remember here, obviously, forever.
Just heard a little while ago.
Yeah.
I was trying to forget. I never quite could.
Right. Well, you walk into this place and you see, I bet you see, it's old home week every 4 years.
Yeah, it's fun to come up here, walk around the garage area this morning. Certainly saw a lot of people I haven't seen in a while. while, saw a lot of friends, saw a lot of crew guys that used to work on my volunteer work on my late models when I raced up here, and see a lot of my family here, Ross's family to cheer him on as well. So it is it's always fun to come home.
Spencer Gallagher in the 23 from 6th to 4th here in the first 105 laps, 95 remaining today at Madison International Speedway. Championship contender Mason Mingus in the Dial 811 Before You Dig entry back in 5th position, still searching for his first career ARCA victory. Justin Boston, who was first earlier off a restart, rejoined the fray after his second pit stop, back in 11th spot after the second caution, now working his way back to the front. Boston up in 6th. They had a fast race start today. Closing in on Mingus in the 32.
Yeah, there's so many guys that have been third, fourth, fifth, sixth, you know, all day long. That's the same group. And
yeah.
It'd be funny. So much is going to mean track position. And if we get that yellow, how you come out of the pits?
Kyle Benjamin in the 15 on the backstretch, lapping Michael Mira in the 69, who brought out our second caution. Ross Kenseth takes advantage, gets right back there in the 52, just under the rear deck lid of the 15 off turn 4. Drop that car to the bottom nicely and lap the 69.
What we see so much in all forms of motorsports are catching somebody and passing them.
Yeah.
Just two different deals.
Yeah, it's been interesting watching the scoring monitor and watching the lead interval. It'll get up to about a second because some lap cars will get down to 3 or 4 tenths. You know, clear traffic, it'll go back out to 8 or 9 tenths. So they've been about the same speed when they're in clean air.
And sixth up for grabs here. Mingus in the black 32 has fifth position. Justin Boston has tracked him down. He can't get much closer than a car length or two right now. They're coming out of turn 4 up on the rear deck lid of the 32. We'll see if Boston's got anything for Mingus on the inside, diving into one.
And we've got some mainstays in the ARCA series, and definitely the 32 car there. Has been so good throughout the years, and all the Venturini cars and stuff. You just know when you come here, those are the guys you're going to have to beat, along with Frank and some others.
Still Kyle Benjamin leading. Ross Kenseth is second, about 7 tenths of a second back right now. Frank Kimble third, another 3 seconds back.
Here we are trying to lap the 55 car.
Right, so, pool, yeah.
Who's currently in 11th position. So they aren't wasting any time getting around there.
You saw the 15 drive off the track into turn 1 there. It's a common problem here. There's a big lip off the bottom, and you try to get that grip right on the bottom. And when my cars used to be real good way back in the day, you can hang the left front off the track off of 2. That's how you knew your car was working right. And he just hung the left front off getting into 1 there, but didn't cost him a lot of time.
Benjamin, the 55 of Brennan Poole, now a couple of laps down to the leader. Ross Kenseth in the 52, first and second, the 15 and the 52, the 55. Looked like it was going to be a contender earlier, but got into that incident over on the backside. Did a lot of damage to the front end of that car. The training team getting the front end more or less taped back together. And the speculation there might have been a brake fire in that car as well, because it looked like they had dumped a fire bottle up on the front wheels of the 55 at one point during that pit sequence. So on the backside, Boston and Mingus in the 32. This is for fifth again, and they're nose to tail heading to turn 3.
Yeah, they're really nose to tail.
And you can see Mingus kind of slipping and sliding there in the middle of the corner.
Yeah, he's definitely
too.
Got his hands full as forward crash.
And these cars have enough horsepower. You can definitely spin the tires.
A lot of horsepower, in excess of 800.
Get up on the 3 car, Carl Weber from Ambia, Indiana, a young 16-year-old driver making his ARCA Racing Series debut today in the MountainMan.com entry. He's trying to get some seat time. He said, hey, my goal today is to finish with all the fenders on the car. Good goal for a 16-year-old driver, his first time in the 3400-pound stock car as well. Here's Boston in the 25, sizing up Mingus, trying to get inside him for fifth. Mason Mingus has that bottom line covered nicely, doesn't he?
Even if he is sideways, that just blocks more. Gets up a little bit there. He gets his nose underneath there. See if he can get a little enough grip to get down there. Nope, it looks like he's going to be able to fill up the hole.
Mingus powers by, or rather the 25 of Boston powers by Mingus going down into turn 3. So give Boston the position as they hit the front straightaway here at Madison. Justin Boston into the top 5. That shuffles Mason Mingus back spots. That does not help Mingus's championship hopes. With 5 races to go in the season, Frank Kimble, the 260-point lead and now an advantage over Mingus of three positions. Kyle Benjamin is in command of the 15 car as we put lap 120 on the board at Madison. International Speedway coverage of the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards on the NBC Sports Network. I'm Rick Benjamin. NASCAR star Ken Schrader is alongside. Jim Trano has our coverage on pit road. We're honored to have former Sprint Cup Series champion Matt Kenseth, who won the most recent Cup race in NASCAR, the night race at Bristol earlier this week. Joining us topside, his son Ross, running second right now in Mr. Schrader's 52 car, making his ARCA Racing Series debut. The gap about 2.2 seconds. And, Matt, you talked about it earlier. When you get to lap traffic, you're kind of causing an accordion effect out of the field.
It's tough to pass cars in general because the competition is so tough these days. But even lap cars, you know, you're used to running the whole track, used to running your groove, and being in a more unfamiliar car, unfamiliar competitors, trying to set up that pass to lose the least amount of time is tough. So the first time they caught lap cars, you saw the 52 close in, and this last time they caught them, you saw them lose almost 2 seconds because the leader got through traffic so much better. So that's always part of the game, is trying to get through that traffic better than the next guy.
As we take a look at the backside, lap traffic will be a factor here for your leader, Benjamin, in the 15. His teammate, Milka Duno, on the low side. He'll get by her. Josh Williams in the 0-2, though, coming off the corner, not nearly as quick as the 15. So Benjamin will have to make a quick move to get around him, I would think. And he'll go to the outside off of turn two. Williams with just enough car to stay in front of him. All this, of course, will benefit Ross Kenseth in the 52 car. Was 2 seconds back last time by the 0-2, still holding up the race leader. And that lets Benjamin scoot by on the bottom, going down into turn one. 75 to go here at Madison International Speedway. Just two cautions so far here today. Ross Kenseth picking up a little bit of ground in the 52 car. When we talk about rhythm, Kenny Schrader, and a racetrack like this, and you know you've got half a dozen lap cars you're going to deal with, maybe 8 or 10 that are in that lead group, everybody on the lead lap. How do you time lap traffic? I mean, are there places where you want to get to people? Do you kind of think ahead? How far down the racetrack do you look?
Well, you're looking pretty far, but you don't always know exactly where they're going to wind up going. Getting your nose up underneath them coming off the turn is probably the safest, most easiest place to do it. But a lot, you have to catch them right to do that. Otherwise, you got to slow down to their speed and follow them through the turn, and you give up speed there. So it's not like you control it. You got to judge it off where they're going to go on the track.
Since these cars are relatively heavy at 3,400 pounds, how big is momentum?
I think it's fairly big, although from watching up here right now, you can tell that there's a lot of people that are hoping there's going to be caution so they come and get some fresh tires. You can really see the cars starting to slip off the corner and spin the tires. So these big, heavy cars don't want to change directions really fast. And like Kenny was saying, when you catch these lap cars, you don't know where they're going to go, but you have to try to set it up to not lose momentum because they don't want to change directions real quick, especially on these old tires.
Well, Benjamin to the 15, just lapping by Tom Hesser.
And on the radial tire, too. The radial tire will go forward unbelievable good. It will turn unbelievable good. It'll stop unbelievable good, but only really likes to do one thing at a time. Yeah. And unfortunately, that's not the way our sport works.
Kyle Benjamin in the SRI 15 doing a terrific job laying down some great laps. Gunning for his first career win in the ARCA Racing Series today. Could be one of the storylines today. Ross Kenseth started on the pole in the Farman Fleet 52. Running in second, 2.1 seconds back. He'll lap under Josh Williams here in the 0-2, one of the other Allegiant Air machines in the field.
You can see them all having trouble with traction, grip, coming off turn.
And if you're wondering about Williams, who held up a competitor earlier just a little bit, held up the leader Benjamin, now Ross Kenseth gets inside him. He's the top 10 car. He's running ninth the lap down.
Oh, yeah, he's a good racer. I mean, he's really performed good in the other Allegiant car this year. And he's one. Your deal is to go as fast as you can. Sometimes you have to work when you see the leaders coming, and it's just common courtesy. And a lot of times it's like, hey, I've got my own agenda here. I can't worry about you guys. You caught me.
Yeah.
You figured out how
exactly
to pass me.
Exactly. Yeah. And he's trying to stay in front of Brendan Poole, who's shown 10th a lap down in that 55, despite the problems they've had today. And the story, of course, with Brendan Poole, last week's winner on the dirt mile at Springfield, wasn't planning to be in the car this weekend. Got the call to come up from Charlotte after A.J. Hendrickson, scheduled to drive, re-injured his right hand yesterday when he contacted pit wall during practice. A.J. Hendrickson, a veteran ARCA competitor, broke that hand originally a couple of years ago at Daytona. It was put back together, and he's been okay, but he jammed the hand yesterday and said, hey, you know, I just can't do this. Let's get a capable driver in there. Brendan Poole with 2 wins and 3 starts this season in ARCA coming in here today. Today a bit more of a struggle. Had to start at the back of the field, has climbed from, he started back around 21st, 22nd spot. He's climbed to 10th right now as we watch race leader Kyle Benjamin with Thomas Prater in the 2 another lap down. Prater 15th right now, but 5 laps down to the race leader.
I love our sport and the way you talk in our sport. It's like, yeah, his hand was put back together and it's been okay. It's just like it was a car, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Well, I hate to think of how many guys we've all known over the years who've had to have something like that done. I mean, you know, how many pins you might have in a hand or an elbow or a leg somewhere, depending on your history as a driver. As safe as the sport has gotten now, it's still something that we have to pay attention to.
Yeah, we need to give a shout-out to Tony. Wish he was here to watch it with us.
Kyle Benjamin laying down some great laps. Meantime, in that 15 car, very smooth. Beautiful line around the racetrack. He's caught lap traffic in perfect order just about, and he's built that lead to 3 seconds over the 52. Given today by Ross Kenseth. Matt, his dad, joining us here in the broadcast booth on the NBC Sports Network.
I think right now he's getting education about how hard to push the gas down without slipping the tires forward, because it looks like you can really spin the tires off the corner a lot real easy. So, like I said, I think a lot of guys are hoping for caution, get some fresh tires, and give you that instant grip.
Right. Quick break for us here at Madison. We'll come right back with more on the NBC Sports Network coverage of the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards. 60 laps to go at Madison International Speedway. Glad to have you with us on the NBC Sports Network, the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards. And Kyle Benjamin doing a terrific job right now in that 15 car, opening up the advantage 3.2 seconds over the 52, wheeled by Ross Kenseth. He was our pole sitter today in the Blaine's Farm and Fleet Schrader Racing entry. Kenny, what do you think? Is this a matter of having to decide whether or not to make a green flag stop? Is there any reason to roll the dice right now as we get down inside 60 to go?
Oh, I think right now they have to be telling Matt that, Ross, that, okay, we have 60 to go basically, and these tires are yours for the rest of the race unless the yellow comes out. So treat them good. Yeah. This is what you're stuck with right now. It'll change when the yellow comes out.
Only 100 miles of racing, these cars do have a 22-gallon fuel cell, so fuel not really an issue in a place like this.
Yeah, I think unless there's a caution, they're stuck on the tires they're on. So I think they're hoping for a caution to bunch it up, get some grip, and try to go race them again.
Points leader Frank Kimmel there in the 44. Spencer Gallagher in the 23 in fourth position. He's about 3 seconds behind Kimmel right now, running by himself, as the 77 Pesser and the 02 Williams battle for position. That's for 8th and 9th just in front of this, and here comes Williams on the bottom. Looks like Tom Hester's starting to struggle a little bit in his Barber's Autoland 77 car. Justin Boston in the 25, running in 5th position, 10 seconds off the leader's pace, had led a few laps earlier today. One of our title contenders, currently sitting 3rd in the championship, 500 points though, behind points leader Frank Kimmel at this stage of the game. That's about 2 full races, the way ARCA points are scored. Back a little further in the field. Next up, Mason Mingus running 6th in the Dial 811 Before You Dig Toyota Camry. Mingus doing a nice job and flirted with the lead earlier, but he's a couple of seconds out of 5th right now in that Wintron entry. On to the back straightaway here at Madison, running all by himself in clean air as well.
It's been an exceptionally clean race.
Yeah.
The boys are all playing good with one another. I've been very happy to see that.
Well, because you certainly don't want to bring the 52 in pieces back home to North Carolina.
You don't want to see anybody get tore up, and it's just a better race when you're actually racing instead of tearing stuff up.
But you're right. He doesn't want to see his car race.
Did you get a phone call or a text from him? Did we talk about that?
We'll talk about it after it's over.
Yeah.
Right now, we shouldn't be talking about any of this. It's probably not good.
Bill Caduno in the 35, the 82 of Mason Mitchell. Now, Mitchell had set 2 consecutive track records at Berlin and last week at Springfield, 2 consecutive Menards pole awards. Today didn't qualify particularly well, but he's done a very nice job. Has raced his way up to 7th. He's the last car on the lead lap. Milka in the 35, meantime, is 13th. 3 laps down to the leader, so she's having a pretty darn good day here as someone who has struggled to learn these race cars. Started out in sports cars, of course, from Caracas, Venezuela. Indy cars for a period, very good at the high-speed ovals, had some success in Indianapolis. Trying to get into stock car racing. This is her second full year in the ARCA Racing Series, learning the ropes here, and on her way perhaps to a top 15 run today in the Milka Way 35.
It's got to be an unbelievable transition to go from an Indy car to a heavy stock car where it doesn't make the downforce, it's so much heavier. It's got to be easier to go the other way, I would think.
That's one of the Tarini entries as well as race leader Kyle Benjamin goes by on the outside, continuing to look smooth. 2.5 seconds to the good here. Of course, we have that situation right now in the Sprint Cup Series. Danica Patrick in her rookie year there out of IndyCars and then out of the NASCAR Nationwide Series. And it's a tough transition. James Hilton brings the Radon.com 48 car down on pit road as well. James in 18th position right now.
I believe James has a birthday tomorrow.
Yeah, 79.
Yes. But this is last year.
He says
this is last year.
How many years in a row have we heard that story?
I think he's serious this year.
Sounds like.
I know he talked to me about driving it because I would be a younger driver. Why are you laughing?
I've heard Mark say a few times it's going to be his last year, too.
Yeah.
Kyle Benjamin continues to lead. Ross Kenseth is second, 2.2 seconds behind. A little bit of the accordion effect coming up here. Benjamin may be held up just a bit by the three car of Weber. As he's on the bottom, that battle between lap cars, the 82 of Mason Mitchell, and then you've got the 48 of Hilton on the bottom. Benjamin catches that group coming off turn four. Mason Mitchell may go a lap down once again. Seventh last car on the lead lap right now, but Kyle Benjamin wants to get around him as quickly as he can. Inside 50 to go. Here at Madison International Speedway, and Kyle Benjamin, Mason Mitchell side by side in three. Mitchell in the Happy Cheeks 82. The Empire Racing entry, and Benjamin able to go through and not lose much time. Ross Kenseth back in the 52 car. The Schrader Racing Lanes Farm and Fleet Chevy. All by himself in clean air.
Yeah, I don't know if there's a lot of clean air out there.
But less dirty.
Less dirty. Less dirty.
So Benjamin with the lead coming out of turn four. 45 laps to go here at Madison.
That's like the race you won last night, Matt. You get clean air. That's great. What, for about 15 laps?
Yeah. They threw the green on that last restart with 40 some odd laps to go, and I took off, and I was just a little, the car was just a little too loose. It's like, all right, we're going to be good. About 15 laps later, I started catching cars and just started getting tighter and tighter and tighter. I was like, it's going to be very challenging this last one, especially in little tracks to get around there in a hurry.
In a place like this where the turn radius is pretty tight. I mean, this is, a lot of people say it's a paperclip, kind of like Martinsville, with more bank.
Very similar, I'd say. It's maybe a little bigger radius than Martinsville, but you run it a lot the same.
There can't be much like Martinsville because I used to run pretty good here. Not so well at Martinsville. Martinsville's been getting better, but it's taken a long time.
Ross Kenseth in the 52. Lanes Farm and Fleet Chevrolet pole qualifier here today. Done a very nice job. Kimmel in the 44 meantime, threading his way inside Bowen there in the black 22. Outside Lira in the 69. Frank is third. He will have another good points day, it does appear, but he wants victory lane so much. I've talked to Frank about this several times over the last many weeks about what it'll mean to him when he finally gets win number 80 in his ARCA career. On his way, it looks to be the 10th time ARCA Racing Series champion, win his 10th ARCA championship. Frank Kimmel working his way by some slower traffic. Thomas Prater in the Realtor 2 car. And up next, Milka Duno there in the 35, and then Weber in the 3. Carl Weber from Ambient, Indiana at age 16, a young late model veteran. I say veteran at 16. You know, from go-karts to legend cars to late models, that transition gets made at a younger and younger stage of life. But he's run a few pass races in the Southeast, a few Jake's CRA Super Series late model events here in the Midwest, and thought he was ready to try his hand at ARCA on the short tracks, and he's 12th right now. We watch race leader Kyle Benjamin work his way inside the 77 of Tom Hessert on the front straightaway, putting Hessert a lap down, Tom in 10th spot. Back with more at Madison International Speedway. Welcome back on the NBC Sports Network. Coverage of the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards. I'm Rick Benjamin. NASCAR star Ken Schrader is alongside Jim Trader with our coverage down on pit road. We've been honored to have former NASCAR Sprint Cup Series champion Matt Kenseth up topside with us here today as his son Ross makes his ARCA Racing Series debut. Matt hot off a victory last night, or earlier this week, we'll call it, in the NASCAR Bristol Night Race, Bristol Motor Speedway, in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series. NASCAR coming back to NBC and the NBC Sports Network in the months to come. Kyle Benjamin started inside row two, was patient, got to the front. Ken Schrader looks like he's pretty darn happy with that race car up front right now.
Oh, I would be. If you're closing in 35 laps to go, you got close to a four-second lead. Right now, he's thinking, I don't want a yellow flag. And I'm sure Ross is thinking a yellow flag would be good. I've got a pit crew down there to strap four new Hoosiers Army and get me back out real quick.
Yeah, I think right now Benjamin's the only one that doesn't want a yellow flag. I think at the end of the race right now.
Right.
third spot, Kimmel, 8 seconds back. Fourth is Spencer Gallagher, 11 and a half seconds back. Dustin Boston, Mason Mingus, Mason Mitchell, the rest of the top seven. We'll take a look back as we see Tom Hessert go by in 10th position. Here's the gap back to Frank Kimmel. Gives you a little bit of a sense when we say seconds, how many car lengths that is. Frank from fifth to third right now, led laps briefly earlier. Out of turn number two, but it's about a straightaway between second and third. Talk about guys who would love to see a caution. Kimmel would be in that group as well.
Oh, most definitely. Like Matt said, if everyone but Kyle Benjamin wants a yellow right now.
Closing in on 30 to go today here at Madison International Speedway. Beautiful day for racing. Late hot summer day here in August. Good crowd on hand as always to enjoy the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards. We hope you're enjoying the coverage as well. The 23, Gallagher in fourth, ran second last week on the dirt mile at Springfield. Driver out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Allegiant Air is the sponsor, doing a terrific job. We'll move up on Carl Weber in the third, in the three car there out of Indiana.
This is all about throttle control right now. Obviously, your car has to be real good, but I mean, you just touching that throttle like there's an egg between your foot and the throttle pedal, and you just barely, this is one of the things, there's 1,000 positions in that throttle, and right now you're just barely using it.
Yeah, there's not a lot of tracks in the Sprint Cup Series anymore where it's this slick. You know, we go to Richmond, you know, it gets like that. Sometimes you don't get the gas all the way down until you get to the start-finish line in a long run. And I got a feeling that's what they're all working on right now, and that's something different than probably what a lot of them have experienced.
In place runner Justin Boston, this is Loop.com 25. How hard is that to teach a young driver? You've got a young son here doing this for the first time in ARCA. Kenny, you work with young drivers all the time. Is that the toughest thing, that discipline, to teach a young driver?
Curbing enthusiasm. But it's you know, everyone thinks it's easier to curb enthusiasm than try to get someone to go. You know, so, I mean, yeah, they'll figure it out. They only need a couple races where they know it hurt them.
Yeah.
And once they figure it out, it's like a light switch.
Yeah, for sure. You know, you always learn to go faster. You stand at the gas harder, you know. And it's,
sure. That's a natural reaction.
Yeah, I mean, it gets to be the opposite. You get a run like this. They've been running 100-some laps green. And, you know, you slow down and you go faster. And you got to be easy on the tires because, like Kenny said about 40 laps ago, these are the tires you're going to finish with if there's no caution. And, you make them mad and burn them off, and you're going to pay for it the last 30 laps.
Mason Mingus there in the 32, the Wintron entry, kind of bullying his way by Michael Lira. That was almost a replay of what sent Lira around for our second caution back almost 100 laps ago.
Yeah, well, there comes that point, too, is you got to learn something the first time.
Yeah. If you're going to be in the way, you're going to get some help occasionally, right?
Well, it's just, I mean, it's like I say, everyone's on their own agenda.
Sure.
You're not worried about what the other guys are doing. You know, you're trying to go as fast as you can, but it just doesn't always work out.
Mason Mingus there working his way through some of the slower traffic, running in sixth. The race leader continues to be Kyle Benjamin, who has led a lot of laps today. In fact, has led 106 of the 175 laps so far. Ross Kentz has led the first 51. Frank Kimmel's led 10. Justin Boston, 8 laps so far today. Brendan Poole in the 55 continues to be a story. Even with that damage he incurred, up to ninth, he's our biggest mover of the day. He's gained 12 spots from his starting spot, 21st, and he took the green earlier this afternoon. Take a look there, Ross Kenseth in the 52, running in second position. But the gap now is 5.8 seconds. If we go green the rest of the way, we've got 24 laps remaining here. It'd be awfully difficult to imagine anything other than a victory lane trip for young Kyle Benjamin in that 15 car, but Ross Kenseth would badly like to have an opportunity and get up there alongside him or get right behind him on a restart. You never know what can happen.
Well, and Frank Kimmel's he's close to Ross, and then Gallagher and Boston are right there too, so it's a long way from being over, and if we get a yellow, it could get real interesting.
On the backside, Justin Boston gets inside the 23 of Gallagher. That's for fourth as we watch the race leader Benjamin on the backside. Moving by Josh Williams, the other Allegiant Air car. Remember, Williams, the top 10 car. He sits eighth right now. There's Mingus in the 32 in sixth position. Making his way by Tom Hessert in the Barbara's Dodge. The 99, Travis Sauter, Tim's son out of Nisita, Wisconsin. Third generation racer. 99, one of the Rulo brothers' Ford entries. Got to be frustrated with those brake problems because we talked earlier today, Ken Schrader, about how that was a car you'd think would be capable of winning. And Travis Sauter, the hottest guy around these parts in late models lately.
Yeah, he's been running extremely good. He was so good in practice yesterday and that, but boy, there's no way to run this place without the brakes.
Travis Travis in 16th position, but with his trip behind the wall, almost 20 laps behind the race leader. Mason Mingus continues to run 6th. Just 6 cars remaining on the lead lap. That's the pace being set by Kyle Benjamin in the SRI 15 out of the Venturini Stables. We'll come back for the final 20 laps here at Madison. Back at Madison International Speedway on the NBC Sports Network, coverage of the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards. I'm Rick Benjamin, NASCAR star Ken Schrader alongside Jim Tredo on pit road. Race leader is the 15 car of Kyle Benjamin. He's led 113 of our 182 laps today. Sprint Cup champion Matt Kenseth is with us topside. His son Ross running second in the 52. We'll find the 52 and the 44 of Kimmel here momentarily. Guys, during the break, both of you saying it looked as though Ross might have problems holding Kimmel off here in these last 15 laps.
Yeah, I think his, but just from watching here, it looks like his rear tires are used up. Like he made him pretty mad, and is backing up pretty good. So looks like he's going to have a hard time hanging on to the third or fourth or fifth here if we don't get a caution.
Well, there's a ton of experience coming up behind him there, and I guarantee you he has not aggravated his rear tires quite as much.
Yeah.
And Kimmel at 51 has been doing this 30-some years. Ross Kenseth making his first career start in the ARCA Racing Series today. And that experience factor certainly does come into play. Justin Boston, fourth. Spencer Gallagher, fifth in front of Mingus. 22 car of Anderson Bowen trailing some smoke over in turn two. This could change the complexion of this one depending on what happens. Benjamin working lap 186. No caution as yet. Starter has the yellow in his hand, though. As we watch Benjamin in three, black flag being shown to the 22 of Anderson Bowen. Looked like something came loose there. Kind of looks like engine smoke, which would mean make you think it's an oiling problem of some sort, overheating possibly. Bowen sees the flag, still up on the racetrack, now drops to the bottom and will bring that car to pit road. We stay green with 14 to go. See what happens now, but the green flag will stay out here at Madison International Speedway. Brings the 22 car down pit road. Very capable race team, the Cunningham Dodge Bunch. Kyle Benjamin stays straight and stays cleanly out in front. 8 seconds the gap now to second spot, and that is Frank Kimmel. While we're watching the 22, Kimmel got by Ross Kenseth in the 52, shuffling him back to third. Justin Boston next in line in his loop 25. He's gotten by now as well. So the 52 car giving up some ground, just hanging on, falling back to fourth position. Learning curve for Ross Kenseth today. Pole qualifier leads the first 51 laps, but that's just not quite enough. We've had a long, long green flag run. Two cautions bunched up around lap 75 here today. We've been green ever since as we close in on 10 laps to go at Madison.
Yeah, he's done a phenomenal job. It's just a learning curve. And that's what amazed me about some of these kids that don't even have Ross's experience. How they come out here and adapt to these cars this quick. I mean, there's just amazing the talent we got out there now, man.
Yeah, it's fun to watch him learn. Like right now, I know he's not having any fun and he's got a real lot of shape, but that's how you learn. You know, you don't get a long run like this. We had some short runs, you get tires on it, and you don't necessarily learn this. So even though, unless something happens here with a caution at the end, he's not going to get the result he was looking for, I bet you when we talk to him, I bet you learned a lot and he'll be that much better next time.
Well, look at right here, we got the 44 and the 25 closing on him real quick as they come into a bunch of lap traffic. So it's amazing. No one's got control of their car because of old tires, and now we're going to get all in a pile and see what we can do.
Inside 10 laps to go at Madison, the 25 of Boston, third spot. Kimmel is second in the 44. These two are championship contenders. Kimmel breaks through. He gets inside the 55 of Brendan Poole, and Boston a couple of car lengths back now as we come up 7 to go next time by. Boston having to fight a little bit with his teammate there, Brendan Poole, coming off of turn two. Poole moved to the outside and gave him room. Now it's clean racetrack for both of these contenders. Kyle Benjamin's lead, meantime, over Kimmel, almost half a racetrack here in Madison.
Yeah, Benjamin has really been smooth. I mean, obviously, the car's very good, and he's done an excellent job of driving it.
Kyle Benjamin will become the youngest winner in ARCA Racing Series history if he can close the deal here this afternoon. There's the gap back to second and third. Kimmel and the Ansel Menards 44. Third spot to Justin Boston. This loop.com 25 out of the Venturini Stables. Kyle Benjamin with a second spot at Mobile, Alabama, race number 2 of the season. Too young to run the big tracks, working only on the short tracks this year. Kimmel and Boston for second spot with 5 to go at Madison. pressure on the leader. Here's Boston diving to the bottom, heading to three. And Justin Boston will close the pass, get around Frank Kimmel, take over second spot.
That puts Venturini cars 1-2.
Strong program. There's no question about that. And Justin Boston will drive away now from Frank Kimmel in the Thor Sport Toyota. Four laps to go for Kyle Benjamin. Make it three to go. We'll have 197 on the board that time by. Scoring strip top of your screen in the Hurs Live Life with Flavor 200 here at Madison International Speedway. Kyle Benjamin on his way to leading 130 or more of the laps of the 200 laps here today. Anderson Bowen back to pit road in the 22 as they have struggled. How impressive is this run for Kyle Benjamin, Ken Schrader, Matt Kenseth?
He's performed flawlessly. And he's just been so smooth on that throttle, not to aggravate his rear tires.
Yeah, exactly. He's been really smooth. He's been fast. You know, they took off in that last restart, but did a really good job of pacing himself as the car under him. And, you know, he's really had good car control, kept the tires on it good, and it's paying off right now.
Kyle Benjamin under the white flag last time around here at the half mile at Madison International Speedway, on his way to becoming the youngest winner in ARCA Racing Series history. He'll post another win. For the Venturini Motorsports crew, the checkered flag waves over Kyle Benjamin in car number 15. Taking the win here at Madison, the battle for second goes to Justin Boston. Third is Kimmel. Fourth will be Spencer Gallagher. And fifth looks like Mason Mingus will be fifth across the stripe in the 32.
It just really shows about taking care of your stuff and just making laps. See, you can't aggravate those tires. And obviously, the Venturini's got extremely good setup there, but there's only one person working the gas pedal and the brake pedal, and he did a phenomenal job today.
In the ISC Racers Tape SRI 15, Kyle Benjamin takes the honors here today at Madison International Speedway. What a great performance for the young driver in his first year of racing ARCA Racing Series machines. And a runner-up finish early in the year at Madison International Raceway down here in Alabama. Two other top tens. Take that 15 car to victory lane for the first time in his career. Nothing like winning your first race in a major series, is there?
Yeah, that's for sure. Anytime you get to do something for the first time is always memorable and always special. So for him to be able to get his first win here and dominate the last 100 or 120 laps like that has got to be a great feeling for him.
Benjamin leads 131 of the 200 laps here today. That's a pretty good button kicking to put up.
Oh, that's extremely good. I mean, he was stout. You know, and he qualified third. Yeah. You know, and they were happy with it in practice yesterday. So there was no reason, you know, not to know that he was going to be a factor.
Benjamin will take the checkered flag around the Madison International Speedway here. The reverse victory lap, always a tribute to Alan Kulwicki. And he will be a happy young man, no question about it. We'll get a chance to visit with him in victory lane in the next couple of moments here on the NBC Sports Network. It's been a lot of fun to bring you these last four events on the NBC Sports Network for the ARCA Racing Series. A terrific series. Ken Schrader, there's a good reason why you field the car in this series, because of the quality of competition and the importance of this series in terms of training young drivers.
Well, that, and I love going to the grassroots, the hometown tracks. You know, I mean, what other series can you come to places like this and still get to go to Daytona and Talladega and Michigan? It's so neat, and run dirt tracks. This is just grassroots racing like it's supposed to be.
Great afternoon here from 15.
Yeah, there's not another series anywhere that's as diverse as the ARCA series, so I follow as closely as I can, probably not as closely as you guys, obviously, but it's crazy. I think they race super speedways, half-mile short tracks, dirt tracks, road courses, all that stuff, so it's a good place to get some experience.
And where you are at the Sprint Cup level, where you might have 20 cars in your fleet in the car for every specific racetrack in some way, Kenny, a lot of the guys bring the same car week to week.
Oh, there's a lot of them that, like, have a Daytona car and the other car.
Yeah.
So, but at least you know which one of the two you're going to run.
There you go.
Yeah exactly. Don't mix them up.
Might be a problem there. So Kyle Benjamin brings the 15 car down pit road. He will come to victory lane. Jim Trado will chat with him in just a moment when we continue on the NBC Sports Network. Our coverage of the ARCA Racing Series on the NBC Sports Network has been brought to you today by Scott Brands. Scott Prep, the cleanup solutions for contractors, do-it-yourselfers, and moms. All available at Menards. By Replay XD, life's in HD. Replay. And by Allegiant. Save with the best travel deals under the sun only at Allegiant.com. Now we'll look at the Scotts Rookie Challenge today here at Madison International Speedway. Through 15 races this season, Mason Mingus leads the points over Justin Boston, Mason Mitchell, Thomas Prater, and James Swanson. And a little further down, today's winner, Kyle Benjamin, seventh in the Rookie of the Year standings for the Scotts Rookie Point Challenge. And here he is.
Madison becoming the youngest winner in ARCA Series history. A huge hug from his crew chief, Kevin Reed. Five victories on the year in this car. Team principal Billy Venturini also coming in to give him a bear hug. He runs the day-to-day operations, and this is something special. This is the Venturini kiss. Andy Granatelli did it a long time ago, and Billy does this to each and every driver. That's Bill Venturini, the patriarch and two-time ARCA champion, giving young Kyle Benjamin a kiss. Now just a nice little peck from Kathy. But indeed, a hug indeed. Kyle, we got to get in here and chat with you, man. What a dominating performance. How did you do it, and at what point did you know you were clicking them off and had a chance to win?
We had a decent car at the beginning, and we had that first caution. We came in and took two early, and Kevin made some adjustments on the car. We were a little bit snug, and we freed it up. Helped it a lot. I'm real proud of my crew chief, because that's the best a crew chief can do for a driver, because we didn't have the car to win at the beginning. He made it one. Congrats to the pit crew for getting us off first. Second, but it was an awesome stop. I'd like to thank SRI and Venturini Motorsports and everybody that made this possible, like Bill Venturini and Billy Venturini.
Young drivers like yourself get a chance to get in good equipment and make the most of it. How does it feel for you right now, knowing now you're a winner and the youngest ever winner in the ARCA Racing Series?
It makes me feel so good. I wanted this so bad. I mean, I really went to bed last night practicing pit stops in my head just so I wouldn't mess up. I didn't want any mistakes this time.
Six times a charm. Kyle Benjamin, a winner for the first time here in the ARCA Racing Series in his sixth start in 2013. History has been made here at Madison International Speedway.
Great performance by that young driver, Ken Schrader. How cool is that?
It's phenomenal. I mean, and he deserves it because he did such a good job. Like I say, a good team and everything, but he was the only one working the pedals.
Justin Boston, Frank Kimble, the top three. Gallagher and Mingus, the rest of your top five. Ross Kenseth ran sixth. He was our pole sitter today, and he's with Jim.
Our pole sitter making his debut run here, Ross Kenseth, on home turf in Madison, Wisconsin. But first, ARCA race, what was the difference for you? You had the lead early, made a pit stop, and it seemed like as the race wore on, your car just wasn't handling right.
Yeah, the guys from County Schrader Racing did a great job giving me a good car. I was short at the first part of the race there, and I wasn't happy with it, how I was turning in the middle of the corner, and I wanted to come in and work on it. It was probably the wrong call. That was pretty much 100% my fault right there. And we did that, made it way too loose, and I couldn't baby it enough not to burn the right rear tire off it. So had that long run, needed one more caution to come in and make up for my bad call there, and I think we've been all right. But disappointing. Huge thanks to Farm and Fleet for giving me the opportunity to race with these guys. It was fun working with Donnie, Bubba, and them guys, and hopefully we can do it again soon. Just real disappointing.
What did you learn today that you'll take going forward?
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. I don't know. We loved that first part real good, and I just made a bad call, and I'm making an adjustment. So 100% my fault. Wish we had a better finish than sixth.
That's Ross Kenseth.
Well, he made us very proud today, and we can't wait to bring him back. I mean, bringing the field down to the green on the pole, what more could you ask for there?
Absolutely. Our Replay XD replay recap. Ross Kenseth was the pole starter, would lead the first 51 laps here. It looked like he had a dominant car going, where things kind of got away from him just a little bit here. Some of this helped around by the first caution of the day. This is Will Gallagher and Eddie Sharp, six on the high side, three wide here. That didn't work. He backed it into the wall hard. Long caution there. And that kind of set off a sequence. Ross came down pit road and had to be penalized.
Yeah, he came in a little too fast. They had to go back the longest line. Plus, they made an adjustment. Just put him back farther, or he couldn't overcome it.
So Ross Kenseth has to take sixth home with him today on the restart. Kyle Benjamin was your leader. There was another incident. Michael Lira and the 55 of Brennan Poole. Kyle Benjamin going to the front for the first time. And then here is that second caution that happened just a few laps later. Off of turn two, young Michael Lira just getting started in the ARCA Racing Series in Bill Kimmel's car. A little help there from Brennan Poole. That was our second caution of the afternoon. And off the ensuing set of restarts after pit stops, Kyle Benjamin back into the lead, leads 131 of the 200 laps here today to garner his first career win in the ARCA Racing Series, becoming the youngest winner ever in ARCA Racing Series history. I want to thank Ross Kenseth's dad, Matt, who came here to Madison after winning at Bristol in the Sprint Cup Series last night. Joining us for much of the broadcast today, we appreciate Matt's presence. We congratulate as well Kyle Benjamin in Victory Lane. Our Replay XD recap, the official in-car camera sponsor of the ARCA Racing Series. Replay XD, life's in HD. Replay it. For Ken Schrader, Jim Trado, And Matt Kenseth, I'm Rick Benjamin, congratulating a first-time winner in the ARCA Racing Series. Kyle Benjamin, at age 15 from Easley, South Carolina, goes to victory lane. Hope you've enjoyed our coverage here in 2013 of the ARCA Racing Series presented by Menards on the NBC Sports Network. Thanks for watching. We look forward to talking to you again very soon.